This is actually a commission that I did for someone, a custom work. He wanted like a dark blue kind of look overall and showed me this mouse pad that had sort of a galaxy theme. And so I went with this galaxy theme over it. And I got this this turquoise and the purple color with Montana colors I got at the art store. If you need very specific or like bright colors, you go to the art store, they just have so many colors. But I have videos on how I do the prep work and more in-depth tutorials. I see the one that I do with like that light with the blue mouse with the speckles on it. Basically, I just sand the whole mouse down with 600 grit to get the paint to stick. With this one, I put a primer on first. I use that 2X Rust-Oleum stuff because it bonds to plastic well. I just put a black primer on because I wasn't sure if the Montana paint would bond to plastic well or not. I've never used it before. And basically, I'm just dripping the paint on, spraying it into the cap and just dripping it on, and then dabbing it with a paper towel. I'm dabbing it down to kind of give it a more splotchy look to go with the galaxy. I didn't just want it to look like drips. And that Montana paint isn't good for drips, by the way, either. It just goes on too thick. It'll just bubble up real big, so you kind of have to put it down. And I'm basically just spraying the paint over it there to give it kind of a faded look. And then I'm using brushes. I use that bigger brush you saw there to get bigger dots, or the little toothbrush. You just spray the paint on something, dip the brush in, and then you just flick it back. I actually got a blister on my finger from flicking so many dots of paint over this fucking thing. But I think it turned out pretty amazing. As you can see, I'm just putting more and more and more layers on. And I'm just using that turquoise, the purple, and then a dark blue, and then black. I'm going over it with the black in a little spots. You can see on that right click, put the turquoise down, and then sprayed a little bit of the dark blue over it. And that dark blue will give it kind of transparent. It changed that blue. It gave it a really beautiful color there. And I'm just putting on more and more and more layers here. You know, maybe it was a little bit too much layers, but I think you can see at the end when you look at it under like a bright light really up close, the layers give it a really cool look and a lot of depth to it. And then here, I didn't have enough time to finish putting on the stars and the clear coat and all that day because I took too long, so I'm reusing the tape here. Definitely do not reuse the tape. As you can see me take the tape off after I put these stars over it. The color of the stars bled through, probably because the tape had been reused and wasn't on there good. So I should have put the stars on first. Now if you're gonna paint the clear coat, you can just let the base coat dry about a half hour and then not have to sand it and paint the clear coat over. Or if you tape the logo off, you're gonna sand very lightly, take some 1000 grit, just sand that texture down slightly before you put the clear coat on. If you don't have time to do it in a half hour, basically you want to learn to let the base coat, as in the colors, call it the base coat, let that dry for a day or two. And then sand everything down lightly with 1000 grit. You spray some soapy water on it when you're sanding it, so you can there it got messed up. Putting on the clear here, if you do mess up the logo like that with the paint, it's a pain in the ass to go fix, but you can do it. You just take a little piece of a paper towel, put it over something small, like the tip of a small screwdriver is what I use, and then you dip the paper towel and the screwdriver in the acetone, and you just slowly wipe away, get the color off where you want it to be clear. Then you can take with the end of a paper clip, dip it back in the paint. It's all spray paint, I'm just spraying it down. You can dip the end of a paper clip or whatever and then go back. That was what I did, and dab more of the stars on. It took forever to fix, but I should have put the stars on first in hindsight, then took the tape off, sanded it, got it ready for the clear. So you can't reuse the tape like that. And I'm using my automotive spray gun with the real professional paint here, and the rattle can paint turns out really nice. And you want to put that bin over it because the paint's so sticky to keep dust out of it, because you get dust in it or bugs that can mess it up. You can't really get them out, especially if it's over the first coat. I'm putting on two coats. And the rattle can stuff turns out really good, but this stuff just turns out like incredible. It's just way wetter and juicier and glossier looking after it dries. And so I'm putting on two coats. Now with the first coat, I just painted over the top of the pieces, but I can see that part there, I painted over the edges of it as well. You want to go over the edges, and when you are painting the edges, you want to paint the edges first and then paint the top. Because when you paint the edges, it'll leave a bit of dry spray over the top, and you don't want that dry spray to dull it out over the top, the last finish, so paint the edges first. As you can see, when you shine a bright light over it, it looked kind of dark overall on the normal light. If you look at it close, here's with the flash, you can just see all those layers just look really incredible. Pretty amazing. Nike. And with that white paint for the stars, I actually mixed in just a little bit of fluorescent yellow. I just sprayed a little bit in after I sprayed the white and then mixed it together to give the stars, make them pop a little bit more.